never make a decision going uphill. When things are tough, when you're tired, when you're under stress, when you're feeling weak, don't make a decision. Not a good time. Wait until the sun comes out, wait until the clouds part, wait until you have a clear head, and then you can make a good decision. The second one, everything in life is temporary, even life itself. Whatever you're going through is temporary. The good is temporary, the bad is temporary. So when you're going through the bad, whether your legs are burning because it's your first trip up to sheep camp, or you're being pounded by the surf at 3 a.m. until daybreak, or you're swimming in a cold Alaskan lake in the wintertime, at some point, that pain will be over. It may not be over when you want it to be, but it will be over. It's just a matter of time. Just 7 more minutes. Keep hiking. Lesson number 3. So this one, Piccolo calls this the Washington Post test, but I'm going to change the name to the CNN/social media test, just to modernize it for the younger crowd. And it's incredible. It's a great test, an incredible way to make sure that you're always doing the right thing. So ask yourself, whatever you're doing, how would you feel if whatever you're doing right now, or at any point in time, was splashed all over CNN or all over social media? We're on the front page of the Washington Post. Would you be proud of what you're doing? Would your parents, siblings, and friends, how would they feel about it? Would you still do it? If the answer is yes, then go ahead and do it. If the answer is no, you shouldn't do it. It's really that simple. Number 4, the most successful people, they're not the smartest. They're not the strongest. They're not the best looking, and they're not the funniest. The most successful people are those who can overcome adversity. Now, when Piccolo was going through his selection, there was a lot of guys who were bigger, stronger, faster, and even better looking than him. But the vast majority of these people did not make it through training. Why not? Because they weren't able to overcome adversity. You see, it's not about the setback, it's all about the comeback. The troop gives us lots of opportunity to overcome adversity, whether it's hiking up to Mount Whitney at 14,000 feet, sleeping in a snow cave that you made, or backpacking in the rain. So just how exactly do you overcome this adversity? Well, that leads me to point number 5. You take the pain of the pain. You give it right back. You be aggressive. You don't let it beat you. You see, pain is mandatory. As you go backpack, you know that, right? Pain is mandatory. Suffering, that's optional. And since we're talking about pain, let's be real. You're going to have to endure pain in life. We all know that. And the nice thing is you get to choose which type of pain you want to endure. You get to endure either the pain of discipline or the pain of regret. So for example, when you're 16 years old and you really don't want to sit down and open that community merit badge book, right, to get it done, or you don't want to go to that TLC because you got something else to do, what do you choose? Do you choose the pain of discipline, or do you just not do anything and kind of let everything slip through your hands? All of a sudden you're 18 and you're not an Eagle Scout. The pain of regret. See, it's real interesting because the pain of discipline is temporary, but it's right now, it's immediate. The pain of regret, that's way off in the future, but it can last a lifetime. If you're going through a rough patch, things are tough on you, ask the guy next to you how he's doing. It takes your mind off of you, and it also helps the person next to you. So when Piccolo was up to his neck in mud for hours, or going through Hell Week, and he was in pain, he reached out to the guy next to him to see how he was doing. When we're out there backpacking on the long term, yeah, we're out there with each other, but we're also out there for each other. Number 7, take care of your equipment. So in training, Piccolo had his helmet, and every week he had to repaint his helmet, sand it down and repaint it. It took hours to get it perfect. He would sand it down, apply some paint, find some imperfections or some drips, wet sand it, 2,400, 1,200, sandpaper. And then sometimes it wasn't just perfect. And that took hours, by the way, just to do that. If it wasn't really perfect, you'd sand down the whole venue, repaint it, and start all over again. And I remember sometimes it took up to a whole Saturday just to get the helmet right. Well, I spend so much time on taking care of something as simple as a helmet. Well, it's real simple. If you can't take care of simple pieces of gear perfectly, how can you be expected to take care of more complex pieces of gear? The troop teaches responsibility and how to take care of gear, right? Our tents, our water filters, our stoves, and our own personal gear too. Number eight, you know when you pull into a campsite after backpacking for 6 hours and you're tired, but you gotta set up camp, right? You gotta get your troop gear organized. You gotta get your bear can set up. You gotta get the sump area set up. And then you gotta help your buddy next to you. And then lastly, you get a chance to take care of yourself. And that's really the order of operations, right? It's team, then teammates, and then self. Don't be that guy who gets into a campsite, throws his pack down right where he's gonna pitch his tent, has a seat on it, and then starts eating trail mix. It's team, teammates, self. Your patrol is your team. Number nine, leave no trace. Leave no trace means leave no trace. Sometimes we go backpacking in places like national parks. We have to pack out our toilet paper. Or, crazier yet, we're in the Whitney Zone, and we have to pack out our poop. Yes, many of us have done that. So there's one story I remember vividly. Piccolo told me a time where he was on a time run in an indoor track in one of the training course. And he was running, and he felt like he was going to puke. Actually, he knew he was going to puke. And so he knew he couldn't leave a trace, right? The last thing you want to do, for example, in a combat situation is leave a trail of puke or snuff rockets so the enemy can find you. So he did what anyone would do in that situation. He kept running. And then went down to the drawstring on his shorts. He tied them real tight. Tucked his shirt in real good. Pulled his shirt up over his head. And puked all down the inside of his shirt. All the time, kept running the whole time. That's leave no trace. One evening, Piccolo and I were talking, and he was leaving for survival training the next day. It was about 3 or 4 days. It was alone out in the wilderness in Alaska in January with instructors trying to find you and capture you. So building the fire was completely out of the question. And actually, the way you slept was you dug a hole and got down to the frozen tundra level and you kind of slept in a hole vertically. But we didn't have too much time to talk because he had to get all of his gear together and get his pack packed. So we hung up, and later that night, about 9:45, I get a text message on my phone. I brought you a picture, Stevie. I brought you guys a picture of the text message, so hopefully Stevie will put it up on the screen. All right, well, the text message said something to the effect of, hey, I'm going out on a Yeah. So yeah, the troops packing list, it's that good. That even our nation's elite rely on going on a survival training mission. So when it comes time to going on an outing, use that packing list every single time you go on an outing. Now, the last story I'll tell you about is something called CoolCom. And it's a final exam of the dive training phase. And basically, it's an underwater fight in dive gear, you versus the instructors. They knee you, they twist you around, they rip off your mask, try to simulate being tossed in the surf. Your heart's pounding, it's racing, you're breathing hard, they rip out your regulator, you can't breathe, or they tie your air hose into knots. You have this free-flowing regulator kind of next to you, and you have to kind of suck off of it, and you have to be able to drink the water and then breathe the air at the same time. It's really tough. You feel like you're going to drown. All of your alarms are going off in your body. You need oxygen. Your body starts shutting down. Things are bad. It's tough. But it's at that moment when all heck is breaking loose that you have to ignore the emotion, the pain, the gravity of the situation. You have to relax. You have to focus. You have to rely on your training. See, when things are at their worst, when things are at their darkest, that's when you're going to fall back on what you already know. And who you are and how you handle something. So train for it. And when that situation handled comes about, always rely on your training. So to summarize the 11, we have never make a decision going uphill. Everything is temporary, even the tough part. We have the Washington Post CNN social media test. The most successful people are those who overcome adversity, take the pain to the pain. We're going through a tough, rough spot. Ask the guy next to you how he's doing. Take care of your equipment. It's team, teammates, and self. Leave no trace. The troop has an awesome packing list. Use it every time. And when things are at their darkest, that's when you fall back on what you already know. Rely on your training. So there you have it. 11 ways our Troop 730 shapes the character of the boys and men in our community. You know, scouting has three aims. The first is character development, right? And that's growth in moral, character, and strength. And the second is citizenship, broadly defined as our relationship to others. And the third is fitness, physical, mental, and emotional fitness. Troop 730 is a phenomenal program that turns out young men with a strong foundation to soar in life. They possess an impressive array of skills and knowledge that allows themselves to take themselves to whatever heights they want to take themselves to in life. So thank you to Troop 730. Thank you for the past 50 years, and I'm looking forward to the next 50.